Hello, it's Kubasek Krzysztof. Welcome in my lesson. Today we're going to make a fancy organic chair. In this lesson, first we're going to create the carves. Then we're gonna use a sweep tool to make these profiles, tubes. Then we're going to use a transformation tool to modificate all of these shapes. We're going to also use a revolve command to make a seat. And we're going to set up design as you see right now. It takes a little bit of time because it's conceptual work, so feel free to make it your way and enjoy. So let's start. Let's create a new file. And first we're going to make a circle to create a profile for our base tube. So I'm going to use the circle and I'm going to place it, as you see, on the axis. An axis is around the zero point. Then I'm going to make a control point curve. And so this is gonna be base shape. You can adjust point as you want. And important thing is to create the symmetry line in the middle of the axis. It will help to place a transformation point to the certain point on that line. It will help us to scale symmetrical or to rotate or to make any transformations. So let's go to the sweep command. So now we're going to use a circle as a profile and the curve we've created as a path to our sweep. Okay, so now I'm ready to copy this shape. So first I need to relocate the transformation point. I'm going to use the zero point, which is a crossing of XYZ of axes. And then I'm just going to use a rotation and I have to choose a certain angle. So I want to copy 30 times. So the angle will be 12 degrees. And each time you have to duplicate that. And remember, if you're selecting objects, you don't have to select each one by one. You can use the grouping selecting as I'm doing right now. To just go to the group selecting by picking up the comment from the top bar and selecting the right group from layers. Of course, everything it depends how many times you want to duplicate that. So you have to use your calculator to count all of these angles. I think I have one too much, so I have to delete it. So just go select it and delete it. All right, so I got base shape. It came out something like a basket. So now I'm going to play with this shape. So I have to select all of the faces of the top of my tubes, as I'm doing right now. And after you select all of those top caps, you have to go straight to transformation tool. So select transform and pick up move and rotate. And now you see this small transformation point. So you have to move it from point the software prompt and goes with it straight to the line, to the top or the bottom point of the line or anywhere on the line. So now I'm going to use one of the arches on the coordinate transformation tool to rotate the top caps. So once you rotate them, the whole system is rotating with them. All objects are transformed into that position. So this tool is really great because it gives you ability to transform your design in an organic way. And also you can modificate any objects you've created on your stage by just dragging the edge or surface and just transforming by scaling or rotating. So let's just give it a little bit more of the transformation. I want to rotate those points to make kind of basket which will hold my seat. If you want to change the position of your transformation point, you can do it wherever you like, and then anything you transform, it's going to be transformed according that point, as you see right now on a picture. So in this point, you can adjust your design as you want. I will do a little bit more of the adjustment and I will finish with this. So, and again, I'm going to replace my transformation tool. And in this case, I'm going to scale. So I'm going to drag this yellow controller and rescale all of those faces according point I've selected previously. I think I'm happy with this shape. So now I have to prepare another curve to create a profile for Revolve comment. And this comment will create a seat object for me. I have to set my view to the front view. And I'm going to draw the curve. I'll just create the half of my profile, and then I'm going to use offset comment. Offset comment will help me to duplicate that curve proportionally according to this the same shape. At the end, I will just close those shapes by just drawing the lines at the end of my profiles. So this will close the loop. So it will help me to make any operations in the future. So in this case, I'm going to use a revolve comment. And you can use one of these edges as a center of rotation. Okay, now I need to just place it on the right place. I'm going to rescale it a little bit. So I will set up in the top view. I will use a transform tool to move it a little bit towards the shapes of my tubes. And I have to swap my view to the side view. And then I have to rotate that to place the angle of those tubes I've created, as I'm doing right now. Okay, looks good. So now I just need to make it a little bit bigger because I want those shapes to go into that hiding curvature inside from the bottom. Okay, transformation is done. So let's just switch all of those sketches off from the groups. Okay, and now I got to go straight to the colors. So I'm going to apply the colors I like. You can do whatever you like about your design. And this is going to be the last part of this lesson. So as you can see, you can make quite advanced shape by using simple comments. This is great about that software. And basically we haven't been using lots of comments. It was just about revolving, curve creating, duplicating, sweeping, and basically this is it. So as you can see, you don't have to use lots of comments to create the great design. So this is it. Thank you very much for watching, and good luck.